Hello YouTube, just a really quick update about my new studio, what we did in this last 2 weeks. Yeah, it's like every day like 2-3 hour maximum. So this is the wall. It's a bit interesting on acoustic wise because it's not a fully closed wall, and I also planned here a small door because I still want to use this section as a storage. But on this door, you can see what's going on with the acoustic. On outside, we have three inch wood and 1 inch gap, 3 inch, 1 inch, 3 inch, 1 inch. But if you can see, maybe you can see from here, this section is with 1 inch gap until, let's say, until here. This one is almost 1.5 inch gaps between the woods. So here I have about 11 decibel reduction, and in this section I have about 8 and 9 decibel. So let me show you how the structure is built. Inside it's a bit different. Maybe you can see. If I go parallel with the camera, yeah, you can see. So, you see the gap is not parallel with the inside gap. So what is doing? The sound is coming in, and because of the really thick acoustic material inside, it start to spread in all direction. But in this gap is escaping. And when it's bouncing back from the back wall, of course, it's want to go through this hole. So again, the effect is the same. So the sound never can go straight to between the gaps. So, and also the deviation is different. For example, here, you can see we have like 1 inch difference. Here it's like 3/4. Again 3/4, and it's growing and growing and growing. So none of the inside gap is matching or parallel with the outside, and this structure is the same on a backside of this wall section. Here on the metal structures we also did this angled mirror, let's say like this, and as you can see, I painted on a bit different color because, my plan is to paint everything to white, but later on I changed my mind. Yeah, on the end I didn't choose the Osmo color, guys, because of the price. We're talking about here like 400 square meter of wood around. So yeah, every cent is matters. I brought here many different kind from this lazur, and I did a test. So only this Dyer Schutz lazur gave me this really nice transparent white surface with let me show you, maybe you can see, with this kind of oiled looking of the surface, which is absolutely matte. So, and I'm really happy with this color. Maybe you can see here how the this goldish kind of lazur, it's really nice together with the white one. This section I painted from the same Dyer Schutz lazur to gray, and I already applied 2 layer, and I just finished this one a couple of hours ago. So yeah, it's still sticky a bit. Here we still have a lot of work to paint the ceiling. The guys already crying about this because they really hate to paint this kind of slanted ceiling with lazur. So it will be really, really, really interesting. And in all other really small elements, it's also painted to this goldish looking. And this is the average plan with the colors in my studio. So let me show you guys the most interesting part in this construction, the studio area. In our last video, I told you guys we will do some kind of really interesting acoustic treatment with this kind of Holz profile, profile wood on the wall. So let me show you. Ta-da! I think it's kind of beauty. So when I first time I showed to the guys what is my plan and how I want to build it, they almost cried about it. But we realized later on the speed of the building of this kind of solution with this wood, it's almost the same speed like the normal one, because after when I produced all these small parts, which is between the lines, it's really fast and really easy. We just have to learn the trick how we can hold the small pieces together and attach the next wood line to it. So all the studio area is made on that way. So let me show you what's the big trick about this solution. Behind we have acoustic treatment, which is about 10 centimeter thick or 8 centimeter, and everywhere we applied a black textile on this acoustic system. This one is contained 2 element, the next one is contained 3, and then 2, 3, 2, 3, 2, 3, 2, 3, 2, 3, and this wall is made like 3, 4, 3, 4, 3, 4, in some places 5, whatever. Maybe you think, this is not a big deal. There is a big trick with that. Each of the element I can move one by one. So what is mean? If in the measurements, is showing me some kind of problematic spot or dead spot or reflection spot or whatever, or my furnitures is doing some kind of ugly spots on the wall, let me show you what I can do. Let's say here I have a reflection spot, okay? So let me move this one down, move this one down, these two up. Now, you know what? Let's move all up. And now what I have here is a total different story. And believe me, I did some kind of testing with that. It's a huge, huge improvement. By the way, why we not did on a bottom part? It's very simple. Most of the problems is coming from the height where you are sitting. So my sitting height is about somewhere here. And also because of the tables and the furnitures and the instruments and the computer and whatever, it's coming to maximum to this height. This is actually the table height. I'm really not interested on the acoustic solution on this height, and this is what we follow the everywhere. Maybe you can see, yeah, so all around in the room we have the same height on the bottom. I already planned here a space for the bass stress. Maybe you can see that's why the last line is not ending on a corner. So I have there like 28 centimeter for the bass trap system. And I think this we also we build by ourselves, because I checked the prices. It's about 4 meter. It's like 100 euro. And here, so this is 100 euro. This is the second 200 euro, 300 euro, 400. So I don't want to spend a lot of money on a bass traps. So we will build some kind of solution on all the corners. I think it's a really unique looking, a really unique how it's working, and really unique how I can adjust each part one by one. And believe me, before we started to paint, We moved everything to the right position. I did hear some kind of really small measurement with my old NTS 500 noise generator, and I'm absolutely fall in love into the results. One guy on YouTube, his name is Leisure B. He has a really nice private YouTube channel with his dog, with his families and whatever. And those guys now also building a studio, actually at the moment. And you can check them out on humanworkshop.com. By the way, this is the place where you can listen and download the Leisure B musics, which is, how it's called? Dark punk alternative. So it's really, really, really dark. I listened a few songs from them and I think it's okay and is kind of fun. So if you like this kind of music, definitely you have to check them out on humanworkshop.com. And this is my message to them about their new studio construction. I hope you guys enjoyed. See you next time. Bye.
Yes. You. Yoffi.